suppose growing up in Ireland, being such a small community, there's always a story somewhere in a town or a village or locally where people haven't quite made it, or there's an excuse. They haven't given themselves the best shot, or they found it difficult being away from home. If I was going to be good or make the most of my potential, I wasn't going to be able to do that in Ireland. Matt, how are you?
Mr. Morgan, good to see you.
Pleasure.
Welcome back to your roots.
Thanks for having me. This has changed.
This is a bit different,
aren't it? This is very different. This only used to be one net.
That's right.
With an old keg of empty beer as the stumps.
Concrete strip.
Concrete strip as well, I remember it. It's good to see so many kids out.
Some of them took the day off school for you, Eoin.
There we go.
You were about so big, Eoin, when I saw you first. And you dragged the bat from the car park there. The bat was as tall as you were.
That sounds about right.
We would have you playing under 11 cricket. You were probably about 7 at the time. And you would caress the ball around and you could manage an innings. It wasn't just a case of get runs and get out. No, it was a case of there's a 1 here, there's a 2 there, and we will just structure an innings. So Eoin became the linchpin. You became the linchpin of the side.
Every time I come back, it just looks small. Everyone when I was a kid looked huge. The boundary was massive, you can never get there. And all of my cricket was based around the nets here.
Sure.
So we'd come and Dad would go and play, or my two brothers would go and play, and me and my sister and anybody who was around, your two sons, would go in the net and spend the whole day there. And very fond memory of my childhood, actually, in the nets. Yeah.
It was a real community-based thing. Everyone lived nearby.
Yeah, a lot of it around. This part of the country is family-based and community-orientated. So actually structuring my life and giving me different disciplines, I thought was very important at a young age. So I'm obviously very grateful for that. The rest of it's a bonus, to be honest. The rest of it's a big bonus. Mm. Mind if I watch?
Mm-hmm.
How you doing, lads? What's your name?
Harry.
Harry, I'm Eoin.
Carl.
Carl, Eoin, how are you? Having a good day?
Yeah.
Good. Beautiful day for you. What's your name?
Sean.
Sean, I'm Eoin. How's things?
Good.
Sean. Was that a leggy?
Sorry?
Was that a leggy?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, very good. Nice. Did you try something different there?
I tried to ball everything.
Okay. Even when you bowl it out of the front of the hand, you still have to get through your action. So instead of just putting it there and not getting through your action. So getting through your action means bringing your hip over, everything, full motion. So still commit to it even if you're trying to bowl it out of the front of the hand. No worries. Come here, nice one. Well bowled, nice.
You just coming in the gate remind me of the background of how far things have progressed since. Every year we have a name or two that impress and we just keep them interested.
Brilliant.
And as long as there's progress, now we have the first class structure in Ireland, there's something for them to aim for.
Yeah, that's brilliant. It's come a long way. Yeah. Well, even today sort of epitomises it, that everybody has come out.
Mm-hmm.
And it shows how far cricket has come along. Remember the days we used to struggle for numbers all the time?
Your formative years were here, and everything that's happened since we feel is very much part of Rush. One of our own has made it big in cricket.
This, he was that height when when I was playing cricket here, and I used to kick his bum every now and again when he'd get out of hand.
It's true. Here's a picture of my dad in 1992. There he is with a Slazenger. I think he was going for a Viv Richards look. So this here is my sister Laura. I'm not sure what age she would have been then. A lot of people won't know that my two sisters were fantastic cricketers and as good as the boys around the house. And they used to compete with us all the time and beat us more often than not. So, yeah, she went on to play cricket for Ireland. There's two girls and four boys, all played cricket at Rush. I would have started maybe four or five just coming down playing in the nets. Probably my first game when I was five or six, playing under 11s, under 13s. Also remember the birth of my youngest brother. My dad never made it because we were playing a game of cricket. And I remember the news coming back, somebody rang the club that Evan had been born. And mum as well, so just showed where the priorities lied. I think the association, I keep coming back to talking about family, but the association it had with bringing us all together, and it was our own thing. It wasn't a very popular sport. It was something that we played together that nobody else knew a lot about in the area. We lived about a 20-minute walk from here in an estate. And when I was 3 years old, I ran away from home because it was a Saturday afternoon and I wasn't at the cricket. And my dad was playing cricket, but I didn't know he wasn't playing here, he was playing away. So I just went on my high horse and walked down to the cricket, and eventually somebody got hold of me and took me home. So it's my safe place, I think, being at this cricket ground. So this is the road I grew up on, and we used to live in that house there, the second one in. We used to play, literally, there's not anything being built here. The playground wasn't there, those houses weren't there, and neither were those houses there, so there was plenty of grass to go and kick a ball and have a good time. And the start of the summer used to be the Grand National, and we used to pretend that we'd run up and down, jumping over the fences, pretending to be the horses in the Grand National. So, yeah, we'd do anything, pretty mad. Yeah, we used to play all our cricket around here. I'll show you around here. It's a bit different to Lords. So this was the strip that we used to play all our cricket on. So the rules were right-hand, my two brothers were right-handed. Me and my eldest sister were left-handed, so all the slips all the way across the wall. You'd have a couple of fielders and then a bowler this end. And we'd play away and it'd be great fun. And you get people walking across the grass here or playing football that would just look at us and go, they are mad. What kind of a sport are they playing? So it's quite ironic. You go from where I learned a lot of my cricket, just playing on the bit of tarmac over here with my brothers and sisters, to the local national school that we never played any cricket. And even probably to an extent where people would definitely look down on you if you mention it. Any comment you'd always get was always around, why are you playing an English sport or a British sport? Which I suppose didn't bother me at the time, but is wrong when you look back at it, completely wrong. Like a lot of our underage interprovincial, so Leinster against Munster, the North West and the NCU were always played in the first 12 days of the marching season up the north. And we'd always travel up with regs in Ireland, always associate the area with where you come from. So a D reg is obviously Dublin. So that would always be predominantly Catholic area, going up and playing in different tournaments. And sort of around the time of all the troubles with a hard border where it's actually very similar to touring the subcontinent at the moment. There's a lot of army around, police around. But being in situations where you can't control as a kid is quite scary. Because if you find yourself going into the wrong area, people turn the car upside down and just burn it. So experiences of that and people associating cricket with being a British or an English sport, I think that sort of always reminisces with me when I think about travelling up the north in the middle of the summer. Where I'm at now is like a huge credit to my family. If my family weren't around as much and supported me through like playing a foreign sport, there's no way I would have kept at it and stuck with it. Sort of growing up around here, it looked completely different at the time. Sort of the opportunity of playing professional cricket was never even a thought. Until we moved from here, sort of in closer into this Dublin city centre. Because I moved school, we moved house, and I moved clubs. And sort of the opportunity to go and travel and explore playing cricket abroad, which was a huge dream. The opportunity to move school, not go to the local secondary school and go into town, and that opportunity would sort of came about through my dad. He thought it was a really good decision for my cricket. They had a specialist cricket coach, which was unheard of around here at the time, and we're going to focus a lot on their cricket. The first year I started at secondary school, me and my dad met with the new Cricket Ireland coach at the time, A.D. Birrell, and sort of said that I wanted to go and play test match cricket. And before we'd met him about 2 weeks previously, my dad sat me down and said, well, what do you want to do? Where do you want to go with cricket? And I was like, I want to play tests. I want to play professional. And he said, that's great. Let's look into it. So I was like 13 or 14, meeting with the head coach, not even close to playing with the senior team. And my dad's, he sort of spoke on behalf of both of us. He said, Owen's made a decision, he wants to play test match cricket, and we're just keeping you in the loop so it's not a surprise down the line. And the national coach was shocked, he couldn't believe it. I'm not sure if he was shocked because of the cheek of me or the cheek of my dad telling him what we wanted to do, but we were certainly, if we committed to something, we were all in. Declaring that I wanted to play for England early was, I suppose, a little bit uneasy for people around me, but it sat pretty nicely with me. You might get called cocky or overconfident or getting carried away, but there's no harm in shooting for the lights. At the time, Irish cricket was completely amateur, a million miles away from either turning professional or getting enough fixtures to improve their cricket. Being 13, 14 years old, I sort of realised that I had to go away in order to pursue what I wanted to do. So that was a sacrifice that I'd have to make. But having made the call that early is, yeah, pretty gutsy.
But I guess the real news of the day is that a gifted young Middlesex player, Eoin Morgan, will make his debut.
Eoin Morgan, not what he would have wanted. 4 runs required on debut. Well, he might just do it in style.
That's his career for Ireland.
Fifth player to play for 2 countries, and for Ireland, of course.
The first time I got called up was against the West Indies at Headingley. It's actually a rain affected game. We didn't play, and then we went to Bristol and I made my debut there. But the whole feeling of having mum, dad, all my brothers and sisters there for the game really does make it special, because they're part of the journey, they're part of the dream, and have been there since day one. So I'm always a believer in debuts are as much about your family as it is about yourself.
Eoin Morgan comes down those famous steps at Lord's. It doesn't matter where you're from, the fact is you're wearing the badge of England. An enormous moment for him and for them, who are waiting to enjoy and appreciate the great talent that walked to the wicket.
The call came out of the blue. I didn't expect to be picked in the test team at all. I didn't think I was close at the time. And again, my family came across. My dad was extremely nervous. I remember he stayed, we had a small flat in Finchley, and the corridor of the flat's tiny, and from 6 o'clock in the morning my dad was up and down the corridor in his shoes, so I didn't sleep past that. So I mean, I go and watch my mates play cricket. I get more nervous than they are. It'd be horrible watching your son make his test debut. And then he left after 3 days because he'd had enough. So
his nerves couldn't take it.
Yeah. But that he cares a huge amount. That's what matters.
There it is. The shot that's made him one of the best ODI players in the world. The Eoin Morgan reverse sweep. First boundary he's hit in Test cricket. Just happens to be that shot.
The first time playing against Ireland for England, I suppose, was a completely different feeling. I'd gotten myself into the position I'd always wanted to be in my life. And I was playing against guys I've played with since I was 7 or 8 years old, so it was quite relaxed in that way, but also a lot of pressure to go and perform and win. The first game we played was at the ground down the road in Clontarf, and it was rain affected from what I remember. And then the other game was here. Packed to the rafters, 10,000 people here, so a great day for Irish cricket. It was the first time they had these stands up.
These Ireland players won't be giving any quarter to England. No love lost between these sides when any sport's being played between these countries.
It's a pretty hostile atmosphere that day. I think they'd come around to it eventually, but initially it's quite hostile, which is the nature of sport. Everybody's going to support their own team and their country. And Ireland played really well. They batted first and I think they got 280 or 300. And we got off to a bit of a stinking start. We were 40 for 4 or 30 for 4. Well, we were happy to get the win.
What a shot. What a way to go to 100. Over extra cover with a 6. Well played, Eoin Morgan. Probably just about back to his best now, the England captain.
Terrific shot. Nice ovation. He got one or two boos when he came in, Eoin Morgan, but he got applauded for his 50, and now there's generous applause here. That was what was once his home ground. He goes through to 100.
This ground is amazing. To do something like that on this ground is pretty special. The one thing that's carried me right through, the one characteristic that's always stayed with me, is the belief I've had in myself. Regardless of the form I've been in, how bad the situation is, I've always maintained either determination or belief, or maybe a bit of stubbornness in there as well, that I can get out the other side of it. And I think that's been an important part, I suppose, in me getting to where I am today. To aspire to get to something and achieve it makes you feel a huge sense of satisfaction.
Playing for England right now means absolutely everything. Every sacrifice that I made, that my family made, it means all those sacrifices have paid off. It's an extremely proud moment. Every time you put on the jersey and you feel like a different person, like somebody who represents a huge amount of people around the country and around the world, but also your friends and family, because they're part of the journey, what you're representing. It's a very proud moment every time you pull it on.